pissed. Like, I was already pissed that she was sitting there talking about him walking in there. Like, why am I taking this hard? Talk about that shit later.
She had that white
dude. I was like, yo. Shut, like, you. I was like, you're pissing me off. Shut the fuck up. Get on my. Yo, hold on. It's like, shut the fuck up. And just grab my dick. You're pissing me off. I did, like, after a while, if she would have kept up, I wouldn't even want to fuck with her. I told her, like, she's like, I could tell you're mad at me. Because you always turn your back to me. And then she was, like, staring at the wall. I'm like, yeah, she was pissing me off with that bullshit. I don't want to hear no fucking no. If I want to fuck, then I want to fuck. Like, don't make me get the thing in my head that I want to go fuck with other bitch. Because if it gets that serious, I don't know what
I
mean.
I saw a money man. I was like, let's get to the point where, like, you tell your girl, I don't like this about you. The only thing I don't like about you. She's like, you can exist or that. And I was like, once a nigga, starts
cheating,
it's not just an
LG fucking bitch. And even if you fuck that one bitch, you gonna keep fucking that one bitch. It's just important. Like, I was talking to my cousin the other day, because he was like, he was talking about how sneaky bitches are. And I was like, yeah, they're sneaky too. And he's like, yeah, but bitches are sneaky. Like, he said, bitches. He said, bitches are fucking niggas. He said, well, yeah, bitches are fucking niggas out of town, or bitches are fucking niggas in town. But bitch, good bitch is so nice to you, and you think you love you so much, that she would be fucking a nigga the whole time she's fucking another nigga, and you will never know. And he said, the thing is, she probably would never tell you. That's some crazy ass shit. Yeah, I was like, you going over there. I didn't say that to her, but in my head, like, her going over there and seeing her. But I tell her straight up, like, you go see her. If shit happened while you over there, just hit me up and drop my ass. You ain't got to tell me what happened. Let me know what happened so I can keep moving. Because if you do some time for that shit, I will flip the fuck out, bro. I will flip the fuck out. Anything can get it.
It's crazy though, because like, you fuck everybody, you're
like,
whatever, I'm
gonna fuck. Yeah. Like, I'm trying to build something, and I don't want her to go see that bitch. And I told her, I was like, the thing was, I keep it 100 with her. When we first fucking with each other, I told her, I was like, you're going to have to fuck with her again eventually. It's gonna happen. Like, I know you're gonna have to, it's gonna be something, because y'all married, so it's paperwork that ties y'all. So eventually, you're gonna have to see her or something. And like, another thing was about her getting an apartment. If she lives with Miss Corey, she can't get some type of housing and shit no more because Miss Corey never paid bills and shit. And she lived with her, she was 18 on her lease. So they tagged her to that shit too. And then the other thing is some shit about she owed the people where her and her wife lived at money and shit. The whole time she was like, I wasn't even on her lease. I just had to get some paperwork done, so they just like pinned it on it. But at least people didn't put her on there. So she's like, I'm calling them, telling them to pick me off the fucking list. I was like, if you have to go in there and talk to her about that shit, like in my head, I'm like, that's gonna bring up all these emotions and feelings. And like, if you already fucked with her when we wasn't talking, like when we wasn't together but we were talking, what you gonna do now? I'm not gonna say, I ain't gonna say shit. I'm gonna let it happen because regardless, I still gotta take care of myself. So if she go do what she do, she ruin it, I always got a plan B. The bitch I work with, like she asked me the bitch, like, y'all still together? And I'm like, yeah. And I tell her all the time, I was like, it's a real shit. It could have been me and you. I was like, the day that we were talking about going out to the movies and shit, I was like, if you would have came to the movies that day, we probably would have went out. I said, I wasn't in time to fuck you like that. I said, we probably would have went out. We would have talked, got to know each other, and I probably would have asked you out. And she just be looking at me with like a face. Because she was like, she said, yeah, everybody else is all in relationships and shit, and I'm not. She's like 18. She's a little cute, young. She got a car. She go to school. And she trying to get out of people's place too. And I'm like, didn't you fuck this up? That's my plan B right there. I'm smooth in that Joe. And I'm comfortable in that Joe. And fucked up, we all work together, but I wouldn't give a fuck. Like, that'd be my new way. Keep it on a low for a little bit. I thought I heard that bitch feelings, but after a while, like...
Nah, she fucking up. I'll go viral.
Oh, I mean, yeah. I mean, if she fucking up, then yeah. I don't give a fuck. The other day, she was like... She was telling me all the reasons why she loved me. She's like, I think I thought, she said, but I fell in love with you. Like, deep in love with you. When you came back into my life. I was like, yeah, don't make me leave again. That's how my name is. She's like, get the fuck out.
Go to orphan room. Go to orphan room. This girl, like, a little bit, you see some pictures. I sent, I did this Facebook shit, and I asked her, I was like, what do you think about my exes? And then she's like, she's like, I wasn't really paying attention.
You dated Nisha?
Yeah. We almost got married.
You almost married her?
Yeah.
Damn.
That's crazy.
Oh, I know. I used to want to fight for her. Like, when we was younger, because I know her, she was younger. Excuse me. I knew her from when we were younger. Did she know you was 28?
No. I don't know. I forgot how I met that bitch.
You did, Michelle?
Nah. But we almost... Like, I tried to fuck her for a while. Like, we went out a couple times. But I didn't know she had a boyfriend and shit. And then... The day that... She hit me up one day. She was all like... She's like, you wanna fuck me? Bring a pack of cigarettes? And I was like, no.
She's like,
what?
Oh, yeah. Hold on, Michelle was the cigarette girl?
The black one. The dark one.
Hold on, she was the one that used to always ask for cigarettes when we used to be chilling over at Taco Bell, and she'd be like, oh, I ain't gonna fuck her. She just want me to bring some cigarettes over.
Yeah.
Like, she fucked for a pack of cigarettes.
And then, I told her no sex. She's like, well, come get your dick sucked or something. Come do something, I'm worried. And I was like, no, I'm good.
For a pack of cigarettes. This is screaming hoe.
I told you about the $40 thing, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that was her and...
And it counted out to $38.
Some girl named Donnie or some shit. That's Michelle, voice box.
That's her too?
Yeah. No. That's two of
each. What the fuck? She was dripping. Yeah.
Why did you send me to the Facebook? Not that, because I told you we did the Facebook shit. She showed me there's supposed to be five niggas that she talked to or almost fucked or fucked. And for me, it was five niggas either fucked, almost fucked, or dated. And then I asked her, right? I was like, so what do you think about my exes? She said, I wasn't really paying attention. And I was like, any female, and their niggas like, look, I'm gonna do this for you.
What's she saying about?
She was like, I wasn't really paying attention. And I was like, any person that shows, that doesn't make any sense. Especially if it's about like female or shit.
See, this one text you said right here, the whole, but the things I do for you, nobody got that out of me. And sometimes I feel like if he does to you, that's how I used to feel when I first started fucking with Disney. Like, I don't just go out my way to do shit. Like,
that's what I tried to tell her, like,
bitch, if I don't like you, all you're getting from me is dick. You barely get in the conversation.
That's what I'm trying to tell her. That's what I'm
saying. And if you get...
I feel like, some niggas, they can fuck somebody and just fall on them. I was like, yeah, I fuck a couple people, and some people are just sex. And she got mad because for the boy's box and shit, I had the two TVs. One day, when she was spending a week over, I got police. And she was like, well, what's this TV for? And I was like, movies? She's like, what you got? And I showed her my list. And we watched like 10 movies. And she's like, movie time. So I told her, I was like, we should start watching movies and shit. And I was like, I'm not gonna lie to you. This is how it started. This is where it came from. I was like, but it's me and you now. She was like, you wanna watch TV with me and you watch TV with that bitch? Fuck that. That's so rude. Like, okay, I talked on the phone with them, so what, we can't talk on the phone? She got mad and shit. Like, sometimes she'll get dumb and shit. And she actually was mad about that shit. Okay, we watch TV together. Like, now, me and you. You know Nicole Slavin?
Mm-hmm.
You know Nicole Slavin? Little black chick?
Cool. Yeah, like that. Probably what I see.
I go up into the library to catch the Hopewell bus for the little walk through shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I seen her, and she had bags in her hand. She was walking on fast with a coat. She seen me, like a block away. She slowed all the way down. And I walked up to me. I gave her a nod and just kept going. She had like the biggest smirk on her face. And I told her, and she was like, oh, you're looking at me. I was like, granted, it was cool as fuck. I wasn't like trying to talk. But it wasn't cool. She still would have got the nod.
Ain't that crazy? Wow. I was just talking to my cousins the other day. I was like, you know, I had so many opportunities to do with me. And even when we were just talking, we're not together, I have a dude to fuck other people. And I told her that. I was like, I really just don't want to fuck anybody else. Even if there's days where I feel like I just want some different person. I, deep down, I really don't want to fuck with nobody else because I like what I got. And I love it like that. And like, when I was in PA, nigga, when I go to PA, it's too late because he's in my military.
Are you talking about that shit?
Yeah. And I was telling my cousin, it was like, they want to have a threesome with a nigga. And one of them wants to fuck me. Like shit.
Hello? Yep. Alright, hold on 1 second. I'm coming right now.
That's right. People notice your room. You got the bed, you got your table, your TV, your computer, your PlayStation. People notice
your room. I know the maintenance man came or whatever, and he's like, he's like, he's like, he's like, he's like, he's like, I did your shit earlier, as soon as I made it.
Was he outside?
I guess so.
Don't say shit, but if he asks.
He's trying to trust him.
Huh? Nah, it's good. Hold on.
No, Patricia. No, I'm playing golf.
You've
been hysterical.
Yeah.
It's the menopause again. That never happened. I'm afraid I cannot be smoking too like that. No, golf, I tell you.
You might wanna if they're here, you might wanna tell Dizzle too. So he don't tell that nigga. And if they not, if they're coming here,
you
might.
You! I swear sometimes upstairs I'm gonna get out the door. Shit, done. You know this button? I did it by accident one day.